Good morning, students, and welcome to today's maths class. So what we'll do today is we'll do a quick revision on what we have studied in the first chapter, that is numbers. We'll do revision and then in the next class we'll start with the second chapter. Alright, so first what we saw in 5-digit numbers, we saw what are 4-digit numbers. We did a recap of what you all studied in third standard. So the 4-digit numbers are nothing but you get a smallest 4-digit number when you add 1 to the greatest 3-digit number. And in 4-digit number, you have 4 place values, that is 1s, 10s, 100s and 1000s. Okay, we saw different examples of 4-digit numbers. So this numbers, these blocks represent 1240 and 3. So that is 1243. And here these blocks represent 2325. Correct. Then we saw some terms to remember. We saw what are odd numbers. So any numbers ending with 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 are called odd numbers. Then the numbers which end with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0 are called even numbers. Then we saw what are predecessors. Predecessors are nothing but a predecessor of a number is the number that occurs just before the given number. So if your given number is 21, then its predecessor will be 20. Then successor is the number that comes after the given number. So as I took 21 as a number, so its successor will be 22. Then we saw what are 5-digit numbers. So when I add 1 to the greatest 4-digit number, that is 9999, I will add 1, I will get 10,000, which is the smallest 5-digit number. In a 5-digit number, I have 5 places, that is 1s, 10s, 100s, 1000s and 10,000s. So this is what we saw about 5-digit numbers. Right, then after this, what did we do? We studied what are large numbers. So we studied large numbers in two numeral systems. One is the international numeral system and another was the Indian numeral system. So in the Indian numeral system, we have 1s, 10s, 100s, 1000s, 10,000s, then after 10,000s, that is your 5-digit number, what we studied just now is lakhs, then after lakhs we have 10 lakhs, after 10 lakhs we have crores, then 10 crores. So when I write this particular number in the place value chart and read it, I have 12 crores, 45 lakhs, 57,631. Then we saw what is international numeral system. So in the international numeral system, up to 5 digits, it's the same as Indian numeral system, that is till 10,000. But after 10,000, instead of 1 lakh, we have 100,000. Then after 100,000, I have 1 million. Then 10 million, after 10 million, which we have 100 million, which is equal to 10 crores. Okay, so this is a number I have taken, and when I insert it in the place value chart, I read it as 14,532,467. So this is what we studied about large numbers. Then what we did, we studied what are face value, place value, and we learned how to compare numbers. So here, first we'll see what is place value. So place value is nothing but it is a value of each digit in a number. So I have a number here, 3679. So place value of these digits will be the value of its place. So 3 is in thousands place. So place value of 3 is 3000. Place value of 6, which is in hundreds place, is 600. 7, which is in tens place, is 710s. And 9 in ones place is 9. Face value. Face value of any number is represented as the value of the digit itself. So if I take the same example, face value of 3 will be 3. 6 will be 6, 7 is 7 and 9 is 9. Then we saw different examples. So these are the place values of these, of this number. Right, then we saw what is expanded form and standard form. In expanded form, we break up a number according to their place values and expand it to show the value of each digit. So we make it as an addition statement. We take a number, expand it with its place values. So here place value of 1 is 10,000, 2 is 2,000, 4 is 400, 5 is 50 and 6 is 6. So I'll write them separately and then put addition signs in between. Standard form. Standard form is the usual way of writing numbers. What is the meaning of usual way of writing number? So if they've given a number in expanded form, then you add it all and write it as a whole number, that is 24,325. Okay, so then we saw what is comparison of numbers. Now if you have two numbers, okay, first rule is if you have two numbers, then the number with less number of digits is the smaller number. But if you have numbers which have same number of digits, then what you do, you see the place value of the leftmost place. Okay, you see the digit in the leftmost place. Okay, whichever number has the leftmost place as greater, that will be the greater number. Now if number digits in the leftmost place are equal, then what you'll do, you'll move on to the second digit from the left. Then if the second digit also are equal, then you'll compare the third digit from the left, and you'll continue until you come across unequal digit at the corresponding places. So the places you're comparing must be same. So if you're comparing hundreds place in one number, you should compare hundreds place digit only in the other number also. Alright, so this is how you compare numbers. So number with a greater digit in that place will be the greater of the two numbers. Then we saw different examples here. So here the first number had greater number of digits, so it is greater than the second number. Here they asked which is smaller. Here the second number is smaller because it has more less number of digits. Then we saw ordering of numbers. What is ordering of numbers? We have two ways to order numbers. One is ascending order. What is ascending order? Numbers are said to be in ascending order when they are arranged from smallest to largest, that is equal to climbing steps. So when you move from a lower level to a higher level, you are ascending. So when you arrange numbers in increasing order, it is called ascending order. Then descending order. Numbers are said to be in descending order when you arrange them from largest number to the smallest number. So moving from the greatest to the smallest is descending order. Okay, then we saw few examples on that. Alright, so now what we'll do, we'll see a few questions on whatever we have learnt in this chapter, that is numbers. Then after all this, we saw what was rounding a number. So when you round a number to the nearest 10, what you do, you look at the ones place. If the ones place is less than 5, then we'll keep the tens digit as it is. If the ones place is greater than 5 or 5, we'll add 1 to the tens place and make rest of the digits 0. Then we saw the same way rounding off to nearest hundreds and thousands and also 10,000. So what you'll do first, whichever place they have asked you to round off a number to. For example, if they ask you to round off a number to 10,000, then what you'll do, you'll look at the digit towards the right of 10,000. That will be thousands place. Now in thousands place, if the digit is less than 5, then you'll keep the 10,000th place as it is and make rest, replace the rest of the digits with 0. If the 1000th place is greater than 5 or 5, then we'll add 1 to 10,000th place and leave the rest as it is. Okay, same way with 100. When they tell you to round a number to nearest 100, then you'll see the 10th digit. Then if the 10th digit is less than 5, then we'll keep the hundreds digit as it is. If it is greater than 5, then we'll add 1 to hundreds place and then make the rest of the digit towards its right 0. Okay, so this is how you round off numbers. Alright, so now we'll see a few problems. So here the first one is to write number names. Okay, so fill in the boxes with the number names of the following numerals. So first one is 71,840. Okay, 71,840. Then we have 32,504. So 504. Okay, then after that, 89123, so that is 89,000 123. Okay, then 60,512. Okay, then 27,050. Okay, because 10th place is 0 and 100th place is 0 and 1's place is also 0. Then 42,338. Okay, 338. So this is how you write number names. Then they have told fill in the boxes with numerals of the following. So let's write the numerals. So 32,361. So how will you write it? 32, then 361. Okay, then 90,445. So 90,000, because thousands place is 0, so we just write 90. Then 445. Okay, then 77,023. So 77, then hundreds place they have not given anything, so 0, 2, 3. Then 65,009. So 65,000, then hundreds and tens place both are 0, so 0, 0, 9. Then 56,358. 80,000, thousands place is 0, 207, so tens place is also 0. Okay, then moving on to next page. Now you have to write the predecessor and successor. So predecessor of 62318 will be what? Will be 62317. Then successor of it will be 62319. Then 472520 is the predecessor. So to find the number, you will add 1. So 47521. That is 47521. Then its successor will be 47522. Okay, then predecessor of 78,500, that is 78,499, its successor will be 78501. Now here first they have given successor. We'll find the we'll find the number that will be minus. So 83125, and then we have the predecessor 83,124. Okay, so this is how you do this. Then fill in the boxes with numerals. So you know how to do this, so we'll not do that again. We did one. Now standard form is given. So how to write standard form? Then you have 7,30,000, hundreds place is 0, sorry, thousands place is 0, then 563. Okay, so 7,30,563. Then we have 50,50,000, 53,000, hundreds place is 0. Then 8,90,700,245. Then 6 lakhs. Then thousands and 10,000 place is 0. Then 371. Then here we have 70 lakhs. So 70 lakhs, lakhs place is 0, 70,000. Then thousands place is 0, then 700, tens place is 0, and then 7. Alright, so this is how you do it. Now here, compare the numbers. So 62,901, 62,192. So here, the hundreds place will compare, because thousands and 10,000s both are same. So then, here hundreds place, the first number is greater, so we'll put greater than sign here. Now here if you count the number of digits, first number has more digits, so greater, and then here we'll compare the thousands place. Thousands place first number is 7, second number is 0, so 7 is greater than 0. Okay, then this number here, if you see, both the numbers are equal, so we'll put equal to sign. Then last one, 3,1543, 3,1005. So first number is greater. Okay. And then ascending order. You know how to do ascending order? That is arranging numbers from smaller to bigger. So let's do that. Which is the smallest number here? It is this. So we'll drag it and put it here. Then after that we have 47,653. So this is how you arrange. So 32,581, 37,385, 47,653 and 48,397. Then here, see here, now 83,487 is the smallest, so we'll keep it as it is. Then 84,844 is the next one. Then here between these two numbers, this is the smallest, so I'll drag it here and pull it here. So this is how you arrange that. Next one, which is the smallest number here? It is this one, so we'll put it first. Then this is the second smallest, third and fourth. So you check each place and then see which is greater and which is smaller. Okay, now here smallest is 36,138, so we'll put that first. Then is 563,189, then 563,819, and then last 6,84,6,8483. Now arrange the numbers in descending order. So first we'll put the greatest number. So here that is 79,425, then 45,000, then 38,000 is the greatest. So this is how you arrange. Okay, so here when you see the second one, 9 lakh is the greatest, so we'll keep it as it is. Then 98,000, then 96,338, then 96,048. So it's already arranged. Last one, now which is the biggest here? It is 42 lakhs, so we'll put that first. Then 4,19,000, 4,53,000, 4,01,000. So 4,53,000 is the greatest. Then 4,19,860, then 4,01,916. Okay. Then here, which is the greatest number here? It is already in the first place. That is 5,39,415. Then 5,28,930. Then 59,347 and 58,293. So this is how you arrange numbers. Okay, fill in the boxes with largest and smallest numbers formed using the given digit. The numbers cannot start with the digit 0. So we saw how to form numbers, right? To form the largest digit, largest number, you arrange the numbers in descending order. Okay, so to form the smallest number, you'll arrange the numbers in ascending order. So which is the largest digit among 7, 8, 6, 5 and 2? It is 8. So we'll write 8. After 8, it is 7, then 6, 5, 2. So the number is 87,652. Then we'll write the smallest digit first, which is 2, then 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, next 60514. So here the largest digit is 6. After 6 we have 5. After 5, 4, then 1, 0. So 65,410. Then next one, the smallest, since you can't start with 0, we'll start with 1. Then we'll put 0. Then next smallest is 4, then 5 and 6. Okay, so 10,456. Then 35128, which is the largest here, it is 8. Then after 8, we have 5, then 3, 2, 1. So 85,321. Then smallest number, smallest digit is 1, then 2, then 3, 5, 8. So 12,358. Then lastly, round off the given numbers to nearest hundreds and thousands. Okay. So first you have to round off to 100, so 6,523. So when I round it off to nearest hundreds, I'll have, to round it off to nearest hundreds, I'll see the tens place. Now here tens place is 2, which is smaller than 5. So we'll keep hundreds place as it is and rest becomes 00. So it's 6,500. Then thousands place, to round off to thousands place, we'll check hundreds place. Hundreds place is 5, so we'll add 1 to 6, that becomes 7. and rest become 0. So 7000. Now 1500 is already, now hundreds to round it off to hundreds, you will check tens place. Now tens place is 0 and it's already rounded off, so it will be 1500 only. Then to thousands place, when you round it off using the rules, you'll get 2000. Okay, so 51,283. So rounding off to the nearest hundreds, it will become 51,300. Then 51,283 to the thousands will become 51,000. Then next 37,689. So that will become 37,700. And it will become 38,000 to nearest thousands. Then 1204 will become 1200 and thousands it will become 1000. Then 39,514. So when you round it off to nearest hundreds, it will become, see here, now hundreds place is 5. So when I add 1 to 9, sorry, tens place is 1. Okay, so that will be 39,500. Now when I'm rounding off to thousands place, hundreds place is 5. So I'll add 1 to thousands place. So 9 becomes 10. Now you can't write 10 in thousands place. So we'll write 0 and carry over that 1 to 10 thousands place. So that becomes 40. So that is 40,000. Okay, so this is how you round off numbers. This is rounding off numbers. So this was a quick revision on what we did in the last class. Last few classes. Okay, now what we'll do is page number 99 in your textbook, value based questions, you have to do it for homework. That is this question. Then page number 100, integrate and higher order thinking skills, try to do these questions for homework. If you don't understand anything, then we'll see in the next class. All right, thank you students, complete your homework and I'll see you all in the next class. We'll start with the next chapter, that is addition and subtraction. Thank you.